Hello and welcome to Eclipse Pro Wrestling. It is your host, David Scheller, here with the second edition of the edited commentary for Eclipse Pro Wrestling. Of course, this is our 41st edition of Eclipse Pro Wrestling. We would like to thank everyone for the tremendous support that you have shown. We are in Reno, Nevada. And we are going to get underway with our first contest, which will be for the Comet Championship in the Ghosts Enter the Graveyard Challenge. Of course, this match finally going to be getting underway. Both of the Entrants have made their way down to the ring. The Comet Championship is on the line tonight, and it will be contested under extreme rules. So the graveyard is not a place for the faint of heart. The Ghost has been quite a dominant champion, now standing at over 50 days as the Comet Champion, taking the place of the second longest reign. Of course, the first being the Sir, the inaugural champion. Mad Villain accepting the condition of the belt, and it is raised above the official's head, and this match is about to be underway. Whilst both these competitors highly respected, we look forward to what they put on here tonight. The Ghost constantly seeming to want to prove himself. Mad Villain potentially hinting at some time away after this match, so I'm not sure what will happen if he is able to win the Comet Championship tonight. But he seems to be getting manhandled right now. Of course, the Ghost, no stranger to fierce competition, defending the belt on pay-per-view against Psycho Shredder. Maybe able to overcome. Mad Villain was going for the chair, but he's laid out. Oh, and that's why you don't introduce weapons into the match. Your opponent just as likely to turn you on your head. The Ghost got nefarious intentions. Well, starting the night off with such a contest is risky. Because, of course, these two, they've got their full energy reserves. They are primed and raring to go. As much as they keep the pace in their entrances, they do get to come on with the most amount of energy. They're not sitting in the back waiting for their matches. They come straight from warm-up into their contest. Well, you'd hope they'd be doing warm-up at least. The ring already turning into a variable playground of doom. So, here we go. Oh, Ghost with the exploder suplex through the table. Could that be it? One, two. Oh, and a kick out. Mad Villain got a fair way to go to get into this match. Seems the champion's quite dominant, even forfeiting his advantage here in this match. Of course, champion's advantage, no count out. Oh, well, retains via countout or disqualification, but Extreme Rules match, no such luck. Forfeiting, as I said. Oh, another roll up there. One, two. Two again. The Ghost. Maybe getting a little bit desperate. Not quite sure what his game could be. Getting for another table. Oh, Mad Villain. Relinquishing that from him. Mad Villain seems to be able to try to keep up with the Ghost, at least when they're on the outside of the ring. Does seem to be overpowered, however, once they get between the ropes. Perhaps that's a testament to the Ghost's more technical skill between the ropes. Mad Villain, of course, a bit of a wild card, as it were. Whereas the Ghost sort of does have his history well traced. Ghost setting up the table on the outside. Of course, he can't actually win there. Because even though it's an Extreme Rules, it is not falls count anywhere. Meaning this has to end in the ring one way or another, pinfall or submission, unless the referee calls for a stoppage. Smart display there. Ghost could have just been in trouble. Fighting back and forth. That table is on fire, by the way, so not sure how long that can last. Oh no, what's he got in mind here? Trouble on the apron, right near that flaming table. Oh no, 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 no. Oh, he's gonna powerbomb him through the burning table. Christ. Mad Villain's gonna have some scorch marks on his back after this match. Holy vey. Here we go, setting up for the Uranagi right dead center of the ring. And Mad Villain has no way to go. Can he kick out? One, two. Oh, the Ghost picks up the win. Brutal contest, however, it was squarely in his favor. Mad Villain having a little bit of trouble between the ropes, and with that burning table, it wasn't far to go. Of course, another win for the champion. We'll be back again for the Enter the Graveyard Challenge next week. Oh, actually, will he? May not. Oh no, he will. Will be, definitely. So, of course, up next we have Jaded Josie taking on Lil Phoenix in a little bit of a contest to determine who can get a bit of momentum in the Lunar Division. Can Jaded Josie, the relative newcomer to the division, pick up an upset over the veteran of the division, Lil Phoenix, formerly known as Lamb? This matchup is underway. Jared Addressi in blue, Lil Phoenix in the red and yellow. Already getting a bit of a tussle, and they're against the ropes. Plus a substantial size difference here in this match. That power difference, that height difference gonna come into play, I imagine. Ooh, Lil Phoenix using her veteran experience, shaking off a lot of the tactical wrestling lockups by Jada Jersey. Of course, Lil Phoenix having to use that skill along with her speed to keep up in this match, and that's why we see the power, that headbutt right there. It's gonna put Lil Phoenix out like a light if she doesn't get it control underway. Doesn't get it under control in short order. Oh, Jade is playing a bit more defensive now. Oh, Jesus, the shots into the midsection there with the knee. And then leg sweep. Certainly seems like JJ's score, and the knees were up. Just as it's going one way, it starts going the other. Bit of a fair exchange so far. Oh no, here we go. Oh! The Jade. That pedigree-esque move. Don't you wish what you're doing right now, but no, here we are. Jade Jersey looking for it. Her signature throwing powerbomb. Oh, and all the way across the ring into the pin. Two. And Lil Phoenix showing a lot of heart as she kicks out. Now the chairs in the ring. Lil Phoenix chasing the steel. Jim Jersey clearly not showing any mercy to the competitor. Yeah, I've seen this before. What you got in mind? Ooh, was almost thrown in there, but Jade Jersey diverts her weight just a little bit. The referee seeing the chair removing it. Yeah, throwing powerbomb all the way across the ring. There we go. One, two. Oh, Lil Phoenix kicking out. What heart by the veteran. Close there. Unfair share of issues in Eclipse Pro. Now trying to rise like a phoenix. Never mind. Oh no. Oh no, not again. Oh, thrown hits all the turnbuckles on the way down. And Jade Jersey dragging it to the center of the ring. One, two, oh, and that is the last straw. Jada Jersey picks up the win after three of those huge throwing power bombs. Lil Phoenix has got heart, but there's just not a lot you can do when you're facing off with the strength of those power bombs. Well, here we go, getting a third contest underway, which will be Anime Bros taking on the Iconics. The new Orion Belts champions facing off with the Australian duo. Of course, the new champions winning the belts off the Dragon at the Final Frontier pay-per-view in the opening match. And it was a brilliant display. There was some signs of tension between the Anime Rose, but I wonder if they've got all that sorted out for tonight. Very interesting how they cooperate together. Of course, we rarely see a lot of tandem offense from the two. Has to have been working on some stuff. Of course, the Iconics are well known female tag team. Haven't really been in the conversation for the Lunar Gemini Championships, but I'm sure if they got a win here, they'd be jumping up the list of names very, very quickly. And just as I was saying, we don't see a huge amount of tandem offense out of Anime Rose. There we go. Practically opening up the match with it. And Ashimai is now the legal competitor for the champions. Oh, and more tandem offense. Okay, clearly they can hear me and they're trying to prove me wrong. Really working together. Clearly been putting in some time, putting in some brainstorming. Oh, Julia Rose almost in a tight spot there, but was able to jump into the Hurricane Rana on Billy Kay. There we go. Could that be it? One, two. Ooh, kicking out straight after the two. Oh, Peyton Royce getting smacked around by Rose. Oh, Billy Kay not taking it now. Flying back to the center of the ring, and it's the side effect. Billy Kay, the pin being broken up by a partner, Peyton Royce. Ashimai not quick enough to stop Peyton. Now, of course, as an Australian native myself, would have to say that I'm a bit partial to the Iconics. They are very fun to watch, all things considered. Do have some very interesting tag team maneuvers, but of course it'd be hard pressed to bet against the champions in this contest. Oh, what a combination of kicks there by Peyton Royce. Now the legal competitor for the Iconics. Unlike a lot of the contests that happen in Eclipse Pro, this one seems to be keeping pretty well within the rules. Haven't really seen any breaking of the five count, haven't seen much spillage to the outside. And haven't seen a huge amount of interference between any of the competitors. And once again, just as I say something, the competitors hear me and they want to say, "No, you are wrong," as they were spilling to the outside. And the referee did only get to the count of three or four. Oh, Billy Kay and sent to the outside with a brutal kick by Rose. I see something here. More tag team action, bit of a choke there. Jeez. Can we Rose choke a bitch out? It's compounding on. Oh, Billy Kay eating another brutal right there. Seems like a new Rose. Oh, the Claymore zigzag combination. Anime Rose pick up the win. Just about taking the head off Peyton Royce. What a win. Get to the next match, which will be the ever-present Guardian of Wrath facing off with Big Boss Man.
Filled with shit for the strong-willed. When the world gives you a raw deal, set you off till you scream, piss off, screw you. When it talks to you like you don't belong, or tells you you're in the wrong field. When something's in your mitochondria, cause it latched on to you like knock knock, let the devil in. Malevolent as I've ever been, head is spinning. This medicine screaming, nick nick nick, let us in. It nick nick like a solid ball. Let your Allen pole bedridden, should have been dead a long time ago. Liquid Tylenol, gelatin, sneak my skeletons melting. Wicked, I get all high
to hell with it. I went through hell with accelerants and blew up myself again. Volkswagen, tailspin, bucket mats is my pale skin. Madwin went from Hellman's and being Ralph in Flaffish. Scribble Jam, Rap Olympics, 97 Freaknik, how can I be down mean? Bazaar in Florida, Bruce Room, slept on the Florida motel then. Dr. Dre said hell yeah, and I got it stamped like a postcard, word to mailman. And I know they're gonna hate, but I don't care. I barely can wait to hit him with the snare and the bass square in the face. This fucking world better prepare to get laced, because they're gonna taste my venom. I got that adrenaline momentum, and I'm not going with them. Never gonna slow up in them, ready to snap any momentum. Thinking it's time to go get them, they ain't gonna know what hit them. When they get beat with the venom, I got that adrenaline momentum, and I'm not going with them. Never gonna slow up in them, ready to snap any momentum. Thinking it's time to go get them, they ain't gonna know what hit them. When they get beat with the, I said knock knock, let the devil in. Shotgun, pip-pip pellets in the felt pin. Cock fuck around and catch a hot one. It's evident I'm not done. Vic venomous, the thought spun like a weapon, you're discarding them. Held against your will like a hubcap or a mud flap. Beat strangler attack, so this ain't gonna feel like a love tap. Eat painkiller pills, fuck a blood track like what's her name's at the wheel. Dan a cup patch through the car in the reverse at the Indian nut crash in India. The back of the just mangled steel, my Mustang in the Jeep Wrangler grill with the front smashed, much as my rear fender assassin. Slim be a combination of an actual kamikaze and Gandhi. Translation, I will probably kill us both when I end up back in India. You ain't gonna be able to tell what the fuck's happened in India when you're bit with the...
God damn, if Paul ever did that in that suit, I will never know. However, now we are being joined in the ring by Big Boss Man. Of course, a lot less theatrics just coming to the end of the ring with a baton. Hopefully he doesn't have to use it here tonight. However, the Guardian is a fierce, fierce competitor. And I'm not sure if Big Boss Man will be able to survive tonight. Here we go, Guardian vs Big Boss Man, Daniel Cole in the corner of Guardian. Matchup underway. Oh, Big Boss Man. Big Boss Man powering through Guardian, jeez. Oh, now Guardian getting back and bit back into it. Fighting off the advances of the equally powerful competitor. Ooh, what a lariat. Puts Big Boss Man down in the corner. These two brutal Goliaths. Very interesting to see who will walk away with the win. Of course, Guardian, as the Guardian of Wrath and part of the Acolytes of Wrath, has been put into this test to make sure that he is capable of being the muscle of that team. To serve a purpose to Wrath, in the words of Daniel Cole. Who, of course, helped set this match up. And now we see Guardian looking for it. We see that triple powerbomb combination. Oh, one. The power lifting up. Two. Three. And that is, that could be it. One. Two. Oh, Boss Man kicks Ant. What a legend. Of course, Big Boss Man, not a weak competitor by any means. Oh, Daniel Cole having a step in there, breaking up the pinfall. Could that turn the tide here? Nice. Now Big Bossman is out on the outside. Daniel Cole's still just standing there, not interjecting. No, now stopping him, distracting Bossman. Bossman being put back in the ring at the count of five. Guardian just quickly joins him back in the ring. Oh, huge stalling vertical suplex. Spine buster. Oh, Bossman not capitalizing on that spine buster. Big boot. One, two. Yeah, I didn't think that was keeping down Big Boss Man. Guardian perhaps looking to take control now in this match. Oh no, here we go. Lining him up for it. Lining him up for that triple powerbomb. And this could be it, folks. One last one for the road. Down. Straight into the pin. One, two, three. Guardian is victorious. Of course, next up we have Glowing Gloria taking on Becky Lynch. What should be a very interesting matchup. Of course, Glowing Gloria got a big match on the next show of Eclipse, being Constellation in a By Any Means match. Should determine who's going to win the Salters for the Nebula Championship. But first she has to get through the last kickout and the man, Becky Lynch. Guardian celebrating his victory. Very interesting indeed.
Bring it to the floor. Yeah.
And here we go, this matchup underway. Becky Lynch delivering a forearm first and foremost, knocking Gloria off her feet. That could be bad, leaving your feet so early in a match. Gloria has had a bit of a complicated run in Eclipse Pro so far. Almost seems to be a case of always the bridesmaid, never the bride. And seems to cross a lot of opportunities, but never seems to be able to secure the big win just yet. Of course, has a lot of fight and is a terrific competitor. He just hasn't been able to capitalize just yet. Of course, Becky Lynch knows all about capitalizing on the right moment, previously being a double champion. We also hope to see potentially Gloria can remedy the opportunities given to her in only a few days time in that by any means match to claim contendership to the Nebula Championship, which will be joining the women's singles division. Here we go, Gloria looking for something big. Could be looking for that pump and overhead. Oh, here we go. No place like home. Not even getting to two. Kicking out of one. Not sure what that's going to do to the psyche. Oh, and Gloria. Kicking out after two. Perhaps a bit too much on instinct, Becky Lynch there. Yeah, we'll kick out at one. Gloria dominating now. Targeting the legs. Perhaps trying to take away the base of Becky Lynch. Looking for something flash now, perhaps. An avalanche face buster. Becky Lynch recovers, takes out the legs, starts landing the boots. Don't know what she's gonna be, how she's feeling after that avalanche face buster and the pump handle overhead. Becky Lynch heading to the top rope. Not a place she's known to fancy. And there's no water in the pool. Bit more back and forth now. Fighting for that dominant position. The belly to belly. Gloria just pushing the advantage now. Kicking out before the first count. Becky Lynch seemingly still got plenty of stamina. Becky Lynch kicking out again. What fight. Definitely bring it to Golden Glory now. Yeah, two. Golden Glory doing a very interesting tactic of putting in the pinfall directly after the move, giving it just a moment of break, and then going for it again. Perhaps trying to catch Gloria off guard. Oh no, here we go. The disarmor. fighting through. Glongoria could just escape. He's able to retrieve her arm and push Becky Lynch off. There he is. Glongoria. Becky Lynch perhaps in a bad way now. Taking two of those pump handle overheads. Oh. Just as I say that, Becky Lynch looked for something big. Oh, Becky Lynch kicks out. This match, certainly good so far. That's not what I expected, or would have expected seeing it on the card. Becky Lynch kicking out again. What will it take to keep her down? Oh no, lining her up. Could this be it? One more for the road. Pump handle overhead. Damn. One, two, three. Glory is victorious.
Welcome to the jungle. motherfuckers say that I'm foolish. I only talk about Jews, do you fools listen to music or do you just skim through it? See, I'm influenced by the ghetto you ruined. The same dude you gave nothing, I made something doing what I do through and through, and I give you the news with a twist is just his ghetto point of view. The renegade, you've been afraid. I penetrate pop culture, bring them a lot closer to the block where they pop toasters and they live with their moms. Got drop roasters from botch robberies, niggas crotched over. Mommy's knocked up cause she wasn't watched over. Knocked down by some clown when child support knocked. No, he's not around. Now how that sound till you jot it down? I bring you through the ghetto without riding round, hiding down, ducking strays from frustrated youth stuck in they ways. Just read a magazine that fucked up my day. How you rate music that thugs with nothing relate to it? I help them see they way through it, not you. Can't step in my pants, can't walk in my shoes. Bet everything you worth, you lose your tie and your shirt.
Since I'm in a position to talk to these kids and they listen, I ain't no politician, but I kick it with them a minute. Cause see, they call me a menace, and if the shoe fits, I wear it. But if it don't, then y'all will swallow the truth, grin and bear it. Now who's the king?
Get 'em, not going with 'em. Never gonna slow up in 'em. Ready to snap any momentum. Thinking it's time to go get 'em. They ain't gonna know what hit 'em
when they get beat with the
rhythm.
I got that
adrenaline momentum. Get 'em, not going with 'em. Never gonna slow up in 'em. Ready to snap any momentum. Thinking it's time to go get 'em. They ain't gonna know what hit 'em
when they get beat with the. I said knock knock, let the devil in. Shotgun, pip pellets in the felt pin. Cock fuck around and catch a hot one. It's evident I'm not done. Fit venom is the thought spun like a weapon. You're discarding them. Held against your will like a hubcap or a mud flap. Beat strangler attack. So this ain't gonna feel like a love tap. Eat painkiller pills, fuck a blood track like what's her name's at the wheel. Then a cup Patrick through the car in the reverse at the Indian nut crash in India. The back of the just mangled steel. My Mustang and the Jeep Wrangler, the grill with the front smashed. Much as my rear fender assassin. Slim be a combination of an action, kamikaze and Gandhi. Translation, I will probably kill us both when I end up back in India. You ain't gonna be able to tell what the fuck's happened in India when you're bit with the
venom. Adrenaline momentum, venom, not going with 'em. Never gonna slow up in 'em. Ready to snap any momentum. Thinking it's time to go get 'em. They ain't gonna know what hit 'em
when they get bit with the
venom.
I got that
adrenaline momentum.
This Fatal 4 are now underway will be contested under by any means rules. That means knockout, pin, or submission in extreme rules fashion to eliminate your opponents. So this will be one hell of a match. Of course, that means no disqualification, no count out. As we head through this match, of course, the competitors Daniel Cole, Wolf's Blood, JKR, and Chancel. It was bedlam from the start. Janet's got the single with Boston in, but JK fights his way out. As well, it is not one fall, it is elimination. That means that all the competitors will have to be pinned or submitted for one man to walk away victorious. Chances got out the table. What he plans to do. Laying it in, Daniel Cole, but catching the spinning heel kick on the back of the head. Busted JKO, looks like Sammy dominant in this change of attitude, change of nature. Ooh, two count on JKO, looks like clearly not here to play around. Chance taking a tumble after Wolfsburg runs into him. Daniel Cole shrugging it off. All these competitors fighting. And the winner of this match will be able to claim contendership to a championship of their choosing. What's on the line here tonight? Chance and Wolfsburg going at it, JKO and Daniel Cole going at it. Wolfsburg now maybe bleeding. Ooh, JKO propped up on the table. What's Daniel Cole got in mind? Oh, no, 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 no. Oh! JKO put through the table. Wolfblood taking the first chance. Oh, no. Here we go. Air raid. Crash. Chance. One. Two. Three. Oh, the Renegade Champion, the first to be eliminated in this match. Now it's down to three, Daniel Cole, JKO, Wolfsburg. Daniel Cole forced retreat out of the ring. Now it's JKO and Wolfsburg in the ring. Oh, sort of powerbomb into the cutter. What's JKO got in mind? Just standing over the body of Wolfsburg. So it's when Daniel Cole in the ring. JKR outside. D Daniel Cole stacking his two opponents in the corner. Oh no, what's he looking for? Oh, he's got them both up on his shoulders. Oh, an avalanche double. Hey, shy. He's taking a moment, taking it in. He's lining up, JKO. Looking for that knee strike. Oh, JKO is eliminated. What a KO. Jesus. Daniel Cole over the top rope into a pin. Could this be it? 1, 2, 3. Daniel Cole picks up the win. With that, a contendership of his choosing. Area. Alright, this matchup yet to get underway. The bell has not been rung. They were meant to be, this match was meant to be for one fall. Here we go, finally getting underway. This matchup finally underway, the bell's been rung. UH Brainbuster's finally returning to Eclipse Pro Wrestling. Facing off with none other than the first Equinox Champions, Blood Moon. Max Fafita just tearing through Blood Moon. Fafita on the bad end of the boot there. Able to rally. Oh, and there we go. I got the tongue and death grip in. Would be enough. Head down, starting to fade. Oh no, he's fighting back. He's pulling away. Got the hand. And fights out of it. Doesn't matter, McAfee still got a lot of power on Pat Downs. Technical not gonna do him so good when he has to fight with the power of McAfee. Ooh, drops Garavir on his head. Here we go. Yucca Mania rolling wild. Garavira. And here we go, looking for it again. Looking for it. Brain Buster! He's down. Could that be it? Oh no, man. That down slides in the ring and it's right there. Mac not happy. Tearing apart Pat Downs. Oh, he's not even the legal competitor. Another headbutt. I mean, head DDT. Garavira now finally using his power to his advantage. Keeping Yuck exactly where he wants him. Max steps in the ring. Doesn't even care what the official's saying. Dang. Both legal men down. Yucca Mania slowly getting to his feet. Max in. All right, here we go. Oh, rolling cutter. Fafita puts down Garavira. Oh no, we'll be looking for it again. Brain Buster 2.0. Oh, Garavira kicks out. Yikes, the strength of that man. Definitely not someone to get on the wrong side of. was after losing the Equinox Championships, haven't been on the best run as of late. While the Moon looking to recover, looking to make David Wise proud. This seems to be a struggle, especially with the caliber of new teams coming into Eclipse Pro. Don't know if Blood Moon still stand in the top team spot. Garagir is in. Yakamania is legal. How much more they have left? Oh, Yakamania's gone for it. One, two, four. Carrot Vera kicks out once again. Just as Yakamania thought he was safe, he catches a brood to the back of the head. Yakamania wants him in that corner, he'll put him back in that corner. And there's only one reason he'd want him back in that corner, and that is for one final third brainbuster. McAfee's legal. Referee's in. One, two, three, and the four. And the New Age Brainbusters pick up the win. What a return to Eclipse Pro Wrestling. We would like to thank all of you for tuning in tonight. Appreciate all the support. It's been greatly appreciated. And until next time, we hope you enjoy your time. We hope to see you next time. And that has been all from Eclipse Pro Wrestling. Until then, goodbye and good night.